This is the Ryder and Lisa podcast.
Brought to you by Yegg Property Pros. Powered by Real Broker. Get a realtor who knows. Call the pros.
It's Ryder flying solo today. Just came across a recent study that uncovered what hobbies women find unattractive and some that they find extra sexy. So here are some of the ones. World of Warcraft, not so much. Stamp or coin collecting, no. But if they found out how much it was worth, they may change their mind. Like if you had a sick stamp collection. Knitting was one of the ones on the list. And so was Facebook marketplacing. So once again, those are hobbies that women find unattractive. I'd like to add collecting ceramic unicorns to that list. Girl broke up with me for that once. You should have seen that collection. And I was so rattled, I just smashed it after the breakup. So I guess she could have stuck around. Some of the sexy hobbies that are on this list. Playing sports, just being active, I think, is a big one. Race cars and woodworking, interestingly enough. You got one that you like?
Yeah, when men breathe.
When they breathe?
Yeah, just a breathing man. Isn't that attractive? When they blink, I don't know. Yeah, I'm pretty good.
Just looking for anything, eh?
No.
And you've got one to add to the list that you like as well.
I definitely find attractive when you go to a sporting event and there's like a baddie rocking like a jersey, double fisting a couple pints, just giving her.
So watching sports and drinking. Yeah, I mean, I think I agree with you on that one. Right now we're talking about this recent study that was done that said like specific hobbies can either be really attractive or really unattractive to potential suitors. So I'm just asking you where you're at. It's 780-784-7107. Jen says fly fishing, so hot. Liz says big ick for snowmobilers. I don't know why. One that I got, this is going to seem a little bit shallow, but like I find, you know, women that compete in sports at an elite level attractive, right? Like whether it's beach volleyball or curling, I'm into it. But hockey, not really, just because I know the smell of hockey equipment. You know what I mean? And so when I see like a woman playing hockey, I'm like, her hands stink. So it's not really for me. That's just my opinion. 780-784-7107. Chelsea says video gaming is a huge no for me. All right, we'll put it on the list. What do you got for us? It's something that you like.
Playing a musical instrument, piano, guitar.
How about the recorder?
I have to work on that one.
You're not sure on that one?
Not yet, no.
Okay, what? Can I get my recorder and play you a song, and then you can tell me what you think?
Sure.
Okay, here we go.
Okay. Maybe the recorder, too. Sounds great.
Yeah. I got Lisa on the phone here. I just need your help. I've got some punchlines. I'm not sure which one I want to use. So I'm going to just, like, see if I can get you coughing. I think that's the best way to tell if it's a really good punchline or not, okay?
Okay.
No, I haven't started yet.
Sorry.
Okay. A man who was targeted for pickpocketing is going viral for attacking the criminals with a large adult toy. I guess you could say they were penalized for their actions. Okay, no.
Okay, next.
A man who was targeted for pickpocketing is going viral for attacking criminals with a large adult toy. I bet they dill don't do that again. Ooh, I got a little cough. A man who was targeted for pickpocketing is going viral for attacking the criminals with a large adult toy. Justice is a dish best served hard. Nothing. Okay, and finally, a man who was targeted for pickpocketing is going viral for attacking the criminals with a large adult toy. Do the stealio, get the dilly-do. Yeah! Apparently, New York City has honored the late ODB with his own day on November 15th. It'll now be known as Old Dirty Bastards Day in New York City. Like, if you didn't know who that artist was, how confused would you be when you're looking through the day's New York City honors? Like, some very touching ones, some special ones, some really famous people. Frank Sinatra Day. You're like, oh, yeah. You know, nah, it's Pizza Day in New York. Okay, cool. And then ODB Day. I feel like there's some older dudes who will get the wrong idea on that one, like on what they can get away with. What's today? We've grown to love her for how real she is on the air. With that genuine swagger also comes some legitimate mistakes. So today we're counting down the top seven bloopers Lisa wouldn't let me air if she was here to stop me. But too bad she's not. At number seven, there are a few words that get Lisa Evans twisted up a little bit. Apparently, 91st is one of those words.
Very slow moving due to construction around 75th and 91st. Firth? Oh, no.
You want to try that again?
75th and 91st.
Yeah, she took a few runs at that. Couldn't get her done. Next up, coming in at number six. Unfortunate mistake when trying to think of the name of a toy. Toys R Us Canada opening an adult zone full of just your favorite childhood products. If there's no pogo ball that cuts your feet open when you jump on it with bare feet, I'm going to be pissed.
I want to play with a Playboy.
Game Boy, do you mean?
Oh, I meant to say Game Boy.
Yeah. Coming in at number five. This was when a big hockey trade just went down during Lisa's Sports Minute. We haven't done that segment in a while. We should bring that one back.
Erik Karlsson is getting traded to the Sharks.
Nailed it.
I know. I know what I'm talking about.
Oh, who was he playing for before?
The Ottawa Hurricanes.
I can't remember. Ottawa gets a lot of Hurricanes.
Ottawa.
Coming in at number four for bloopers that Lisa wouldn't let me air if she was here. Dead air in radio isn't a good thing. Lisa didn't know that, apparently. Okay, so camel milk, you're a no. Would you try it if it was free and like chilled?
Maybe. I can't decide.
Great answer. Really compelling
stuff.
I'm so
riveting. This is why I have a full-time job here.
Takes a nap, wakes up, maybe. Counting down Lisa's bloopers that she wouldn't let me air if she was here. I think I'll get in trouble for this one. Number three.
Sorry, my stomach hurts. I don't feel good.
Breakfast burritos will do that to you. At number two, another traffic update. Sometimes those don't go well at all.
Westbound White Mud Drive at 159th Street. There's a stalled duck. I meant to say truck. That's it. Oh, no. Yeah. No.
Oh,
yeah.
Is there a stalled loon out there, too? I'm glad if she was going to mix up the word truck with a rhyming word that she went with duck. That could have been real bad. And at number one for Lisa's best bloopers that she wouldn't let me air if she was here. It's back when Grant Johnson was on the show with us. And we were talking about bunnies.
You should get an actual rabbit.
They're back already? What month is it?
I don't think rabbits go anywhere.
Rabbits don't, like, go south for the winter.
Oh, yeah, right.
Five simple words. $1,000. It's Ryder and Lisa's 1K Wordplay. Brought to you by Out of Bounds Restaurant.
We are joined by Nia, who is 13 years old. My daughter, who is 11, loves this game. And the other day was trying to figure out a way that she could play it somehow. She's like, what if my stepdad calls in? He's not related to you. Do you think I should let her play if she's ever caller 7, Nia?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if the bosses would agree with that. It would sound pretty sketchy, giving her $1,000. But completely cool if I give you $1,000, okay?
Okay.
A little bit different today as Lisa's not in studio. She's out sick, but I have called her and I got her answers. So it's very similar. We're not going to put a time clock on you today just because there's a lot of moving parts. But I've asked her 5 words, and she's given me the first word that comes to mind for each. I'm going to give you the same words. For every answer that you guys have that matches, you get $25. If you hit them all, it's $1,000, okay?
Okay.
Let's do this. Nia, you tell me first. What is the first word that comes to mind when I say church?
Pray.
Let's hear what Lisa had to say.
Pray.
Yeah. We're off and running. What's the first word that comes to mind when I say pool?
Water.
Let's see what Lisa had to say.
Swim.
Oh. Okay, we're not getting $1,000, but I still want to give you $100, so let's try. What's the first word that comes to mind when I say peanut?
Butter, maybe?
Butter.
Yeah. $50. What's the first word that comes to mind when I say dance?
Party.
Party.
Whoa! Nice one. And for $100, what's the first word that comes to mind when I say moon?
Night.
Stars. Ooh, that one was hard.
She said stars there.
Oh.
You still did very good, and I thought both your answers that you didn't line up were really good. Moon and night is awesome, and so was pool and water. So well done, Nia. You got $75. Great game.
Thank you.
We may know who has the next residency at the Sphere. U2 has been doing shows there. And I know my brother's going to it in early December, so it's still around for a bit. But it could be Beyonce. She's reportedly in talks to produce a $10 million stage show in residency at the Sphere next year. Do you hear? That's according to the New York Post, though, and they pump out some absolute garbage sometimes. So it's just a rumor at this point, but would be pretty cool. You know who I'd really like to see there? You know that the Beatles came out with a song a couple weeks ago, even though only 2 of the members are still alive? That was with technology. They were able to create something pretty special with an old recording. They made it sound new. Sounds amazing. What if they did that for a show? Like, think of the opportunities with that Sphere and how technologically advanced it is to go to a Beatles show where a couple of the remaining members are there performing and then everything else is like digital, like to get to see John Lennon play with the, I don't know. I feel like the opportunity is there to do something pretty incredible, but in the meantime, I'll gladly take Beyonce.
The Ryder and Lisa Podcast.
Brought to you by Yegg Property Pros. Powered by Real Broker. Get a realtor who knows. Call the pros.
Play 107.